When we gaze up at the stars, it's easy to forget that the picturesque dots of light we see are actually massive balls of fire floating in space, which burn at unimaginably high temperatures, just like our own sun. One day, some of these stars will eventually die in a giant explosion so bright it can momentarily outshine the entire galaxy. It's a cataclysm that scientists refer to as a supernova.
A supernova happens when the nuclear fusion powering the star is no longer strong enough to prevent gravity from causing a massive collapse of all the matter in the star. And the amount of energy released is incredibly intense and happens in a very short time.
If you have a star somewhere around at least 8 to 10 times more massive than our sun, when it dies, the entire star rushes inward and bounces off of itself, releasing a tremendous amount of energy in one spectacular burst. And so, when the largest stars in the universe die, all that material from the star swirls around and launches these beams of radiation that appear to us as a gamma ray burst. And gamma ray bursts represent some of the most powerful explosions that can happen in the universe.
Could gamma rays that originate light years away actually pose a threat to life here on Earth? According to experts, the answer is yes. Because unlike the normal types of solar radiation that we experience every day, gamma rays are often described as death beams from outer space.
Gamma rays are the most powerful form of light or electromagnetic radiation. They're more powerful than ultraviolet light. They're more powerful than X-rays. They're all the way at the top of the scale when it comes to energy light can have.
Gamma rays are off the scale in terms of dangerous radiation. Even short exposure to gamma rays could scramble your DNA. Extended exposure to gamma rays are the absolute top of the scale, and over time will basically liquefy you.
A gamma ray burst could easily destroy not just one star, but many stars in the process. We're talking about the energy released is comparable to the Big Bang itself, the creation of the universe. If a gamma ray burst were to happen in our vicinity, not only would it affect our solar system, it would probably wipe out all the neighboring solar systems as well. And so this is a threat that could affect a good sector of the Milky Way galaxy itself.
While the hypothetical threat of a dying star destroying our solar system is terrifying to consider, is there any evidence to suggest that our planet has been hit by gamma rays before? Curiously, the answer lies at the bottom of the ocean. July 5th, 1999. In the scientific journal Physical Review Letters, a group of German physicists announce a remarkable discovery. By analyzing deep-sea mineral deposits, they are able to detect a rare iron isotope not typically found on Earth. Known as iron-60, it is formed only in the explosion of the most powerful supernovas, and its presence on Earth proves that our planet was once struck by gamma rays.
Not all gamma ray bursts have happened billions of light years away. Some have happened much closer to home. In fact, astronomers estimate that about 2.6 million years ago, there was a significant supernova outburst that may have led to what we call the Pliocene megafauna extinction, which eliminated something like 30% of all large animals living in the ocean at the time.
The best theory we have for the cause of this gamma ray burst about 2.6 million years ago is the death of a massive star that was 160 light years away. This sounds far away, but in cosmic scales, it's actually quite close. So that kind of gives you a sense of the scale of this explosion.